Hello everybody, my name is Dee and welcome to Books and Quirks. Today I'm here to do a tag video. It's the 50 questions you've never been asked before tag, and I was tagged by Cheryl over at CR Flames Fan, and I will put all of the information including the questions in the description below in case you want to do it. And yeah, so it's 50 questions, so this may take a while, so you may want to grab a cup of tea and just sit back and relax, and hopefully you enjoy. So I have my phone here just so I could see the questions, but number one says, what is your favorite candle scent? I really love candles, but I don't enjoy any like citrusy type scents or fruit or food. I really like clean scents, like, you know, like clean laundry or fresh linen, or I love the outdoor smells, like especially around Christmas. I love, you know, the pine smells. And yeah, so those are the scents I really enjoy. Number two says, which female celebrity do you wish were your sister? I don't know. I like a lot of the older celebrities, the celebrities that were famous in the like 90s and early 2000s. I think Julia Roberts would be so much fun. I wish it was brother, because I always wanted Tom Hanks to be my brother, but that's not the question. The question is sister. Cameron Diaz, I'm a huge fan of. I don't know. It's hard to pick just one. Kate Winslet is another one that I really love. I think she would be a fun sister. And Emily Blunt. Emily Blunt, I just love. And oh, Kristen Bell. I'm going to pick Kristen Bell. Kristen Bell is not an older actress, but I love her so much. So much fun to watch. And yeah, Kristen Bell. Number three says, which male celebrity do you wish were your brother? There you go. That's the question I wanted. Tom Hanks. I love Tom Hanks. He seems like so much fun. I've been a fan of him since I was very, very little. I mean, he started making movies, I think, before I was born. But anyway, he's just a fun, fun guy. Like, whenever I watch him in interviews, I just think he's a good guy and a nice guy and a fun person to hang out with. Number four says, how old do you think you'll be when you marry? Well, I'm already kind of old. I'm in my 30s. I'm not married yet, but hopefully I will be married. I don't know. I'll be old when I get married, if I get married. Number five says, do you know someone who is a hoarder? Now, I don't know someone who is a hoarder in those shows that you see on TV where there's stuff piled to the ceiling, but I did know this woman once, a friend of the family, and she had a small apartment in a very urban area, and her apartment was just cluttered. I mean, there was just these small spaces where you could walk through. I mean, her hallways and rooms were narrow anyway, but just because there were things on the floor and everywhere, that's the closest I think I've come to knowing a hoarder. So yeah, I just always wanted to say, you know, you want me to help you clean? but of course you can't say that to someone. Number six says, can you do splits? No, I was never able to do a full on split. I've always been able to get kind of close to the floor, but there's always like a few inches of a gap between the floor and me. So, no. Number seven, how old were you when you learned to ride a bike? I think I was pretty young. I think I was maybe 4 or 5. My parents got me one of those little bikes with the training wheels. And by the time I think I was 6 or 7, I rode just, you know, a regular bike, a regular two-wheel bike. So I was pretty young. I don't remember the exact age, but I think it was before I started kindergarten. Number eight says, how many oceans have you swum in? Only two. Only the Atlantic and Pacific. Number nine says, how many countries have you visited? Unfortunately, I haven't visited as many countries as I would like to. I still have a huge bucket list and I've only visited 5. Number 10 says, is anyone in your family in the Army? No, I've had My grandparents aren't alive, but I know that the men in previous generations were in the war, World War II, but in current times, nobody is enlisted in the army that I know of. Number 11 says, what would you name your daughter if you had one? I think it would be either Emma or Elizabeth. I love those names, and those are two of my favorite heroines in my favorite Jane Austen classics. The next question says, what would you name your son if you had one? If I had a son, I would want to name him something like Aiden or Jackson. I love Jackson. Yeah, I think Jackson is probably my favorite. Number 13 says, what is the worst grade you've ever gotten on a test? I would say a failing grade. I was a very good student. I was very conscientious student. I got pretty much A's, but I do remember a time when I completely spazzed, completely forgot there was any type of test, and I failed. I got like a 30. I mean, it was so unusual that the teacher even called me up and wanted to talk about it to say, you know, what happened? This is someone like you. You know, you go from getting A's constantly to getting a 30 on a test. So that didn't happen to me too often, but that was one that I remember clearly. Number 14, what was your favorite TV show as a kid? As a kid, I loved Fraggle Rock. I loved a lot of cartoons. I remember Chippendales Rescue Rangers and DuckTales. And yeah, there were so many. I could picture them in my head, but I can't remember the names of all of them. But yeah, I was a big cartoon kid as a growing up, and Fraggle Rock was kind of an offshoot of the Muppets, and I liked Fraggle Rock. I didn't like the Muppets growing up. Number 15 says, what did you dress up for as a kid when you were 8? God, I don't remember. My mother made my costumes when I was young, but I remember one time I was like a space girl, and one time I was just your basic princess. I went as Dracula one year. I mean, I don't remember exactly what I was at age 8, but one of those. Have you ever read any Harry Potter, Hunger Games, Twilight? Yes, I've read the entire series of all of those. Would you rather have an American or British accent? I think it's hard to say because there are so many accents within America, but I do love the British accent, so maybe I pick that. Number 18, did your mother go to university? Well, my mother went to college. She finished about halfway. She was about halfway done, so she didn't complete her degree, but she did go partway. Number 19, are your grandparents still married? Unfortunately, they're not alive. Have you ever taken karate lessons? No, actually, I would, thinking back, it would probably be something that I would love, but I never, it was never on my radar. 21, do you know who Kermit the Frog is? Yes, my favorite green frog. What was the first amusement park you visited? I'm sure every state has their state fair, and we have one in the Meadowlands that comes in every year and it has a lot of rides. I would consider that an amusement park, and that was probably the first one that I went to. And then when I was a teenager, I remember going to Six Flags a lot. So, yeah, Six Flags Great Adventure. I don't know where you are if you heard of that, but yeah, it's a fun, huge amusement park. Which language would you like to be fluent in? I've tried to learn both Spanish and German over the years, and I've just never kept up with it. And I still would like to learn both of those languages. Do you spell it gray or gray? So Gray or Grey? I spell it Gray. Yeah, does anybody spell it with an EY? I don't even know. Is your father bald? Partially. Do you know triplets? No, I always thought it would be fun to know triplets. I have several sets of twins that I've known throughout my life and even in my family, but no triplets. Do you prefer Titanic or The Notebook? That's hard because I love both. I'm a huge fan of both, so I am not going to pick and say which one I like more than the other because they're both equal in my eyes. Have you ever had Indian food? Yes, it's very good. What is your favorite restaurant? I don't know if I have a favorite restaurant. I frequent a lot of, just casual places, different bars, different pubs, just places that you can hang out with your friends. And the chains that you've all heard of. I frequent, TGI Fridays, Applebee's, Chili's, all of those places. I love Tex-Mex. So any restaurant that offers that, I love. Have you ever been to Nando's? No, I'm not even sure what that is. Is that a restaurant? No. Do you belong to any warehouse stores? Just Costco, I think. I don't know what other stores are considered warehouse, but Costco is. What would your parents have named you if you had been the opposite gender? They would have named me Sean, they said, and I forget what middle name they said, but Sean for my first name. What's your nickname? Well, obviously, if you've watched me any length of time, my nickname is Dee. My full name is Deirdre, but throughout my entire life, nobody could ever say it. So I just go by Dee, and that's how I introduce myself, even at work. People introduce me as Dee rather than my full name. The next question says, who is your favorite person in the world? My favorite person, I don't know. I don't have any brothers or sisters, but I would say my cousins. I'm not going to pick a specific cousin, but they're probably the most important. Oh, my godmother. I'm actually going to override that by my godmother. I love her so much. Would you rather live in the country or the city? I think the country, but I would like to live close enough to the city where I could visit, like I could do a day trip to the city. So no more than like a couple of hours away by commute. I've always lived in a very urban type area, but I've always wanted to live in the country and have nice quiet, have like nice have a lot of like woods and wildlife and things like that. Can you whistle? No. Oh my God, my mother can whistle and she tried to teach me as a child and I could never do it. Either with the fingers or just by pursing your lips. I couldn't ever whistle. I don't know what's wrong with me. Do you sleep with a night light? No, but I do have a couple of those lights that will light up based on motion. So if I get up in the middle of the night, one of them will go on because it'll feel me walking to go to the restroom or what have you. Do you eat breakfast every morning? Not every morning. I try to eat something every day, but there's some days where I'm just rushing around and I don't have time. The next question, do you take daily pills or medication? No, the only thing I take daily, and I've tried to be good with this lately in the past few years, is vitamins. What medical condition do you have? I don't have any medical conditions so far, so yay for being healthy. How many times have you been to the hospital? For myself, I've only been to the hospital once that I know of. I got my tonsils out when I was like 8 or 9, maybe. I don't know how young I was, but that's the only time I've ever had to be in the hospital. Have you ever seen Finding Nemo? Of course, I love Nemo and I love Dory. I love Ellen. Number 43, where do you buy your jeans? This is such an odd question. Some of these questions are so weird. I don't know. I buy my jeans everywhere where I don't shop in a specific store. I guess the mall. I don't know. I don't know. I shop online also a lot. So I don't know if there's I don't have a specific place that I go to specifically for jeans. What is the last compliment you got? I don't know. My godmother usually gives me a compliment when I see her, but I don't remember the last one that I got. I can't even think that I've got one in the past few days or anything like that. But yeah, I'm gonna skip that one. Do you usually remember your dreams in the morning? No. Sometimes when I first wake up, like in the first couple of seconds, I'll have a glimmer of something, but it immediately goes away. And I've always been one of those people that just doesn't remember their dreams. Like I'll remember maybe one dream a month and that's it. And I'm always so excited when I do remember a dream because it's so rare. I just don't remember my dreams for the most part. And it's very frustrating. I'm very jealous of people that, you know, always remember their dreams. I think that's so kind of cool because dreams are wacky sometimes. The next question says, what flavor tea do you enjoy? I love black tea, but I've also tried teas that mix different things in it. Like I love teas with chamomile in it, but sometimes they have other things like lavender in it as well. And I love those types of teas, so I try to buy them. The next question, 47, this is how many pairs of shoes do you own? So many shoes. I need to actually get rid of some of my shoes because I just have too many pairs. Number 48 says, what religion would you raise your children to practice? I don't know. I probably let them choose their own. I wouldn't raise them to, you know, practice any one particular religion. Number 49, how old were you when you found out Santa wasn't real? I held on as a kid for the longest time, too long. Even when kids at school already stopped believing, I don't know, I wanted to hold on to that magic. So I really admitted that I knew he wasn't real when I was 9. But I mean, I knew for a while, because I knew that once I admitted it, once I said it out loud, the magic would be gone. And I didn't want that magic to disappear. And it did. And number 50 says, why do you have a blog or a YouTube channel? And I think we would all answer this the same. And I've said this many times in other tags and such. And it's just that I love the community. I love the friends that I've made. I love all of you that take the time to watch me. And I just love a place to talk about books and other related topics. So, whew. Those were 50 questions that I just went through. So hopefully this video isn't too long and I'll be able to cut it down a bit. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Remember, I will put all the information in the description below, so check that out. And I'm not going to tag anybody in particular. I'm going to see, you know, I'm just going to put the information in the description. And if you want to do this, please do it. Because I think it is just a fun tag, even though some of the questions were a little bit strange. But I will see you all very, very soon. Bye.